Good morning, good morning, good morning. Carry on, say. This is your Oracle Jewel of the Dawn back with another reading. And today we will be looking into the situation regarding Leo. So, how's everybody doing? I am doing well. Prayerfully, everybody else is doing well. Prayed, meditated, shuffled, and laid out the cards. So, we're not going to stall it out much longer. We're just going to get right into it. Okay, Leos. So, this reading here, all of the readings for this month, because I'm so late in doing them, are going to be called Something to Look Forward to, okay? Because it's the end of the month going into a new month, so, you know, a lot of this energy is going to be to come, right? So, energy surrounding a situation at the head of the read, which is on your mind, is balance, angel of balance. Trying to balance things out, of course. Recent past energies is the thinking man, and that goes hand in hand with the angel of balance. Like, you're thinking about how to create balance in your life. At the base of the read, which is the reality of the situation, we have the walking away card in the reverse. So either you're not walking away by choice or by force, okay? And adjacent possibilities to the right of the read, which is future energies, like there's like not having any other possibilities. And that's why I say by choice or by force, because there's no other possibilities. Maybe some people in the situation, maybe some Leos, their counterparts, or however this resonates for you all, some people aren't walking away because they don't have any other possibilities, or they feel they don't have any other possibilities. Okay, so first, I feel like I need to say this. Clearly, I'm not in the shop. I am on location. You're going to hear a lot of noise in the background. Just, y'all, please bear with me, okay? Just please bear with me, all right? So, anyways, back to the read, okay? So, it's like thinking about how to create balance in your life because you're not walking away because you feel as if there's no other possibilities, or there are no other possibilities, okay, Leo? So then from the romantic angels deck, we have flirt, extend your lighthearted energy to others, and then we have calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you together, okay? So then up next from the abundance deck, we have ask for your needs to be met. God and the angels can come to your aid only if you make a free will choice to be helped. And it begins with asking. It doesn't matter how you ask God for help, but only that you do so. The same holds true with clearly asking other people to assist you. And then we have take a divinely guided chance. All positive change and successful ventures involve a degree of risk, and you are ready to follow your divine guidance to new territories as you leave behind that which is comfortable and familiar but no longer appropriate for you. You make room for new and more meaningful opportunities. So that card right there, in between the walking away in the reverse and the adjacent possibilities in the reverse, is telling me that there are some people, some Leos, counterparts, or however it goes, that aren't walking away from a situation because they feel that they don't have any other possibilities, which would be the equivalent of being stuck or not walking away by force. But the cards are telling me here that you need to ask for your needs to be met. Maybe ask for the direction that you should go in. Ask whether you know what you need to do to create that balance in your life. And I feel like for some of you all, leaving certain people, places, or things behind may be what's needed to create balance in your life. And you may be thinking about doing that, but you aren't doing it. And you're being guided to take a divinely guided chance. Like the card says, as you leave behind that which is comfortable and familiar but no longer appropriate for you. So I just feel that in love and in life, there's some things that the Leos are supposed to be walking away from. And I remember not too long ago, I was talking to the Leos about blocking your own blessings. If you're considering yourself stuck and not leaving behind people, places, things, behaviors, thought patterns, etc., etc., you know how it resonates for you. If you're not leaving behind certain things that may be hindering you and creating an imbalance in your life, then you are doing yourself a disservice, okay? And you are a part of the reason why you have imbalance in your life, and you are in fact blocking your own blessings, okay? So let's dig a little deeper and see what's going on with the clarifying cards. All right, so let's start at the base of the read because we had a jumper walking away in the reverse. For some people, I saw a couple of stories when I was looking at these cards. For some people, there is a family situation because the walking away in the reverse card is being clarified with the Ten of Wands, the King of Pentacles, and the Ten of Cups. There are some people, some Leos, counterparts, however it resonates, that are not walking away from a situation that is a burden. It's a lot of work, but I feel like there's a Leo man who has a family, and it's a lot of work for him to maintain the family because the family is kind of dependent on him for stability. And he's not walking away because he wants to see the family happy. Also, another message that I got while I was shuffling the cards and while I was meditating over them, there's a woman out there that's dealing with an either married Leo man or a Leo man who, you know, has children and maybe in a civil union, common law marriage, whatever you want to call it, shacking up with a woman and with his family. However, he's not going to leave this family. That's just a message that I got intuitively as I was shuffling the cards. Because, you know, there's still love there. It may be a lot of work. He may be feeling burdened or whatever. But, you know, he wants to see his family happy. And he's not going to leave them. Okay? Let's go to the recent past energies. We have the Thinking Man card, which is being clarified with the Page of Wands in the reverse and the Queen of Swords in the reverse. Somebody's thinking about how to level up, how to mature, and how to do it righteously. Somebody's thinking about how to grow up and be mature and stop coming in a Page of Wands, little boy. And I'm getting a lot of masculine energy in this read. It could be a Leo woman as well, trying to level up over, I guess, a guy who's immature. But I feel like there's a man who doesn't feel like he's at the level where he needs to be. And he's trying to level up, strategizing. At the head of the read, the Angel of Balance card is being clarified with the Knight of Wands in the reverse and the Five of Swords in the reverse. That has a lot to do with somebody, like I said, somebody was dealing, whether it's the Leo dealing with somebody that was in a relationship or had family ties or whatever, or the Leo was being promiscuous out here. I feel like their balance is going to come with not being a player, not this in and out, you know. Wands represent the phallus. The knight is on the field, you know, just being out in the field, being thotty, so to speak, and not walking away. That's how they're going to create their balance, by not walking away from a situation and not being a player anymore. Leveling up. Like I said, leveling up, being righteous. Not being in a little boy state of mind, strategizing on how to create balance. Because with this Knight of Wands card in the reverse being next to this flirt card, I think them and their flirty nature, whoever it is, whether it's the Leo or their counterpart, their flirty nature was kind of causing imbalance in the relationship. So in order to create balance, they have to stop being in the Knight of Wands or flirt energy. And they're thinking about it. They're thinking a lot. I think it's a lot of self-reflection going on here with the Leo or the counterpart of the Leo. There's a lot of self-reflection here. And I believe it's because this card here. Like, when you know that you've called in your soulmate, or you've met your soulmate, you're already not engaged to be married, but engaged in relation with your soulmate, and you're in this kind of energy, you can lose your soulmate. So I think there's a lot of self-reflection going on here, because I feel like somebody is thinking about how they were being immature and how they need to be righteous. They are thinking about how they were flirtatious and in this Knight of Wands energy, and I think they kind of neglected the relationship and caused imbalance and caused, you know, people to walk away from them. And whoever walked away was a soulmate, or is thinking about walking away, or threatening to walk away, was a soulmate. And it's going to take a lot of work, first of all, to stop this person from walking away, Leo or counterpart, however it resonates. It's going to take stability. It's going to take for somebody to stand up and grow up and be somebody that's consistent, and be somebody that can provide, that can protect, you know, to be the head of the household in order to save this household. And I feel like somebody's willing to put up a fight for it, whether it has to do with money, because I see this King of Pentacles cards is the money here. So somebody is leveling up, trying to level up as far as their finances go. And somebody's also, it could be the same person, but somebody's trying to level up as far as finances go. Somebody's trying to level up as far as maturity level goes. Somebody's trying to level up as far as being a player and learning to be faithful and commit. Somebody's trying to level up here. And then for future energies, we have the Adjacent Possibilities card in the reverse, being clarified with the Nine of Swords in reverse and the King of Cups. So for me, this is just saying that I think, like I said, with all the self-reflection going on, it was a lot of anxiety that was caused because of certain negative actions and certain immature actions on the part of the Leo or the counterpart, and it's caused stress. And whoever is responsible, they know that they've even caused stress within themselves, but they've caused stress within their counterpart. Excuse me, y'all. They've caused stress within themselves, and they've caused stress within their counterpart. I'm sorry, I'm looking at my phone. I got a phone call. And I'm waiting for it to stop ringing so my music can come back on and block out some of this noise in the background. But yeah, the immature actions, or like the immature actions, the cheating, the infidelity, the being a burden financially or not being able to help out financially has caused stress and anxiety. And it made either the Leo feel hopeless and that there were no other possibilities, or it made the other person feel like stressed out and there's no other possibilities. I can't do this no more. But as they say, love conquers all. Like, somebody's going to step up. Somebody's going to step up to the plate, or at least they're strategizing and thinking about how they can, and offer more and bring more to the table. Alright. So, when I ask to answer the questions on the heart and the mind of the Leo for late June going into July, the answer was choose a new direction. Choose a new direction. Choose, just to correlate it into the reading and the cards that are already out, choose to be from being immature and inconsiderate to being righteous. Choose from being a player and neglecting the situation to being a stand-up guy and creating balance in a relationship. Choose to work a little bit harder so that you can help provide and protect the family if that's where you want to be. Because somebody was not doing things completely the right way, but they're being told to go a different way, go a different direction. If this is what you really want, you got to step up to the plate. These are kings here. You got to step up to the plate, sir or madam. If you're dealing with a Leo, or if you're a Leo dealing with somebody who was married, you need to choose a new direction. Okay? Because it's a family involved and they're not leaving and they want to work it out. And I feel like they haven't necessarily told you yet. But this card is also about truth. So maybe they haven't told you because they're being immature. And they're kind of thinking like, how can I tell this person? All right. So there's a deck I have called The Good Word, and it has a lot of Bible script. It's a deck of Bible scriptures, and I feel like everybody could use a good word with their something to look forward to. And this card that I pulled for the Leo late June going into July card, it reads, I can do all things in him who strengthens me. So whether you're the person who needs to, somebody needs to leave somebody alone, you'll find strength in it. A person working on their family, you'll find strength. Okay, so that's what I have for you all, Leos, for late June going into July 2019 with your something to look forward to read. That's what I'm entitling all of these this month because it's so late in the month. So, y'all, I just pray that this message was received with open ears, open hearts, and open minds. This is Jula the Don signing out, sending love, kisses, and blessings. I'll get with y'all later. You heard. Peace.